Genesis 3 verse 8. And they heard the sound of the Lord God walking in the garden in the cool of the day. And the man and his wife hid themselves from the presence of the Lord God among the trees of the garden. From the beginning of time, God has always derived pleasure in revealing himself to man. We see this in the Garden of Eden as he visited Adam and Eve in the cool of the day to have fellowship with them. This went on until they sinned, and God cast them out of his presence. You know, God is holy, and sin cannot stand before him. Sin separated humanity from God. God became inaccessible to man because of sin. However, man's sin did not stop God from reaching out to men. God kept revealing himself through diverse means. Until Jesus Christ came, every single time God revealed himself and his presence was made manifest, he always looked completely and utterly terrifying. When God appeared to Abraham, he appeared as a smoking oven, a smoking furnace of some sort moving through the air. Genesis 15, verse 17 and 18. And it came to pass, when the sun went down and it was dark, that behold, there appeared a smoking oven and a burning torch that passed between those pieces. There was an unbelievable heat and unbelievable blaze. When Abraham met God, he saw a smoking furnace traveling through the pieces of the dead animal. God's presence at this time was absolutely terrifying, and not something so easy to behold. When Moses first had an encounter with God, he was afraid because God appeared to him as a burning bush. No normal human being would stand without being terrified at the sight of a burning fire and a roaring voice. Just imagine hearing the voice of God audibly and seeing a bush on fire, but the bush wouldn't burn up. Exodus 3 verse 2. And the angel of the Lord appeared unto him in a flame of fire out of the midst of a bush. And he looked, and behold, the bush burned with fire, and the bush was not consumed. God's presence was terrifying. When Moses requested to see the glory of God, God did not show him his complete body. I will paraphrase the conversation between God and Moses in Exodus 33, verse 18 to 28. Moses said, "Please, show me your glory." But God said, "You cannot see my face, for no one may see me and live." And the Lord said, "Behold, there is a place by me where you shall stand on the rock. And while my glory passes by, I will put you in a cleft of a rock. And I will cover you until I have passed by. Then I will take away my hand, and you shall see my back, but my face shall not be seen." No person can see God and live. This is one of the wonderful things about God. The level of power and glory he exudes cannot be withstood by any man. No human can look at him and live. What an amazing God we have. Do you know what Exodus 33 verse 20 tells me? It tells me that what God said in Isaiah 55 verse 8 and 9 was right. "For my thoughts are not your thoughts, neither are your ways my ways, declares the Lord. As the heavens are higher than the earth, so are are my ways higher than your ways, and my thoughts higher than your thoughts. God is so much higher than we can ever imagine or dream. Our human mind lacks the ability to have a full grasp of his greatness. The Bible tells us that when Moses came back from Mount Sinai, after seeing the back parts of God, his face radiated so much so that the people could not look him in the face for days. His face was so bright he had to put a veil over his face. The people didn't see God himself. It was only the radiation of his glory on Moses they saw, yet they couldn't stand it. Doesn't this tell you how powerful God is? Abraham and Moses were not the only ones who had an experience of how terrifying the presence of God is. Job also did. When God appeared to Job, he came in the form of a whirlwind. Then the Lord answered Job out of the whirlwind and said, If you have ever been in a tornado, you know how truly terrifying that must have been for Job. Imagine being presented with the full force of nature in front of you. The frailty of our human structure and mind will quiver at the manifested presence of God. It isn't even something we can manage to stand. This was what happened when the manifested presence of God filled the temple in 2 Chronicles 5:13-14. The priests could not stand. They couldn't even minister to God. The Bible refers to God as Almighty God. We can see why he is called Almighty God. There is a beauty and power in God that our human body cannot handle. With our current bodies, we cannot see God and still live. This is why God promises us that our bodies will be transformed into a glorious one before we would be able to behold him. Our earthly bodies cannot enter heaven to be with God because they are corrupted by sin. So, God has designed a new body for every believer in Jesus Christ. This new body is incorruptible and immortal. This is why we will have glorified bodies at the rapture so that we can look at God, because God told Moses no one can see him and live. For us to see God and live, our bodies have to be glorified. Philippians 3:21. Who shall change our vile body, that it may be fashioned like unto his glorious body, according to the working whereby he is able even